Today, I will show how to design and build a resonant loop antenna for 70 centimeters ham radio. Of course, we will also measure and test it. And this video is about building a loop antenna for the 70 centimeters amateur radio band. What I particularly like about this antenna is that it implements a bandpass and a powerful antenna at the same time. This improves the resilience against strong interferers from adjacent frequency bands. We have designed, built and measured the antenna for 2.4 GHz and 866 MHz in previous episodes. I will link you the videos on the top right. The principle of this antenna is actually very simple. A ring with a circumference of one wavelength is excited with its resonant frequency and thus acts as a filter and an antenna at the same time. Unfortunately, there is a hurdle to overcome. Since this type of loop antenna has a fairly high radiation impedance, a suitable matching network is needed for it, which is not easy to calculate. That's why we at Electronics Unmessed have developed a dimensioning tool based on Excel. It allows you to design such an antenna for different materials and for an arbitrary frequency band. As you can see, it might be worth subscribing to the channel. As a hobbyist, you want to get by with the material that you either already have or you can at least get it cheaply. In my case here, I'm using an N connector and a thick and stiff grounding copper wire. I also use two connection terminals, a piece of insulation cable and a heat shrink for insulation. Of course, we need a soldering iron, solder and possibly a lighter to heat up the solder joint a bit if our soldering iron is not strong enough. Okay, now that we have chosen our material, we need to calculate the layout. The cross-sectional area of my copper wire is 6 square millimeters, the diameter is 2.8 millimeters. You can also use a copper tube, for example with an outer diameter of 5 or 6 millimeters. That would further improve the electrical quality and the mechanical stability. The Excel tool from Electronics Unmessed helps us now with the layout. I recommend also some earlier videos, which are explaining how the tool works. I link them for you in the top right corner. Okay. Now let's enter our desired center frequency directly. For the 70 cm amateur radio band, it is 435 MHz. Then we enter the wire diameter D of our wire. Of course, we don't know the distance S yet, so we enter a reasonable starting value here. I'll just take 7 millimeters. We don't know our feed angle alpha yet either. I just choose 15 degrees for it. Finally, we enter the relative effective permittivity. In our case, it is equal to 1 because the antenna is only surrounded by air. So, now let's look at the impedance at the input of the matching network. We get 79.58 minus J72.27 ohms. The impedance is of course not the one we would like to have. We would like to have a good match to our 50 ohms feed line. So here comes the magic of the Excel solver tool again. Here below we enter the real part and the imaginary part that we would like to have. So the real part of the impedance Z should be 50 ohms and the imaginary part of Z should be 0 ohms. Now, as shown in the previous videos, let's apply the solver to the cost function below. We call the solver and we define that the target value should be a minimum. Then we enter the fields for the distance S and the angle alpha as variables, and off we go. The solver immediately finds a very good solution by varying the values for S and for alpha. The resulting cost function is really very small and the impedance is actually 50 plus J 0 ohms. Cool, isn't it? We have practically already calculated the layout of our antenna for 435 MHz. The distance S must be 10 mm, the angle alpha is 11.8 degrees and the diameter D is 219.52 mm. In addition, other interesting inputs are obtained, such as the ring's radiation impedance and the impedance of the two-wire line that serves as the matching network. The graphic on the right shows us the course of the impedance of the matching network in the range of plus and minus 30% deviation from the center frequency. In this representation, the 70 cm amateur radio band from 420 to 450 MHz only corresponds to about plus and minus 2.3%. If we reduce the frequency steps to 0.23%, then the graph corresponds to the entire 70 cm band available for amateur radio worldwide. We can see that the matching is quite good over the whole 70 cm band. But as said, we are only looking at the matching network here. The entire antenna has a lower bandwidth because the loop only has the calculated impedance at its resonance frequency. And it will naturally deviate when we are not on its resonance frequency. Okay, here we have summarized the dimensions for our layout. Now I want to give you another idea to take with you. The sizing tool can also calculate a foil antenna. In an earlier video, I had already shown a makeshift foil antenna for 866 MHz, which also worked very well. We may later build a proper foil antenna to replicate. What frequency range should we take for this? Tell me in the comments below. It is always very helpful if you draw a template beforehand. I will provide you with my template again in the download area below. This time the template doesn't fit on a DIN A4 sheet. You have to print it out twice and glue it together to get the complete template. I will link you to an earlier video in the upper right corner where I described the build process of such an antenna in more detail. I recommend it because it gives some tips and tricks for soldering the antenna together. Let's take a look at the result right now. Assembled and soldered, the antenna should look like this. Here we have the matching network consisting of our two-wire line. And here is a close-up of the feeding point. It is still variable, due to the luster terminals. In the previous projects, we always hit the resonance frequency quite well. But we have to keep in mind here that we need mechanical deviations of the ring to be less than 1%. This is not a problem for an industrial manufacturing process, but it is a challenge for the hobbyist. The distance S of the two wire line, on the other hand, is rather uncritical. By the way, you can check this with the Excel tool. Just vary the distance S a little and keep an eye on the impedance set. For example, if we increase the distance from 10 to 11 mm, then the imaginary part of set increases to 4.8 ohms, the real part stays exactly at 50 ohms. The magnitude of set increases to 50.23 ohms. This still gives us a very good match to our 50 ohm feed line. The variation from 10 to 11 millimeters corresponds to a deviation of 10%. So, as I said, that is rather uncritical. We can now play through such a variation for all parameters in order to understand where we have to construct our antenna particularly carefully. Now I want to show you a measurement with my nano VNA. The loop antenna for 435 MHz is the largest one I have built so far. Actually, I thought that tuning would be easier with a larger antenna. In principle, this is true, but unfortunately, I had unexpected resonances in my measurement setup in the lower frequency range, which significantly disturbed the reflection measurements with my nano VNA. It took me a lot of time and nerves to tune the antenna, but in the end I was able to prevent the resonances with long ground wires on the equipment. Here is the result. We get the best matching at 435 MHz. Since our antenna should have a bandpass characteristic, it is of course also interesting to look at a broader frequency range. We take the frequency range from 100 to 2800 MHz, which is almost the entire measurement range that our nano VNA can cover. Below 400 MHz, our antenna is a short circuit, and around the 70 cm band, indeed, it has a bandpass characteristic. We also see that our antenna has three resonant frequencies in that range. Namely, at the first resonance frequency of 435 MHz, at 1475 MHz and at 2523 MHz. The higher resonant frequencies are approximately odd multiplies of the first resonance frequency. And this behavior is likely to continue at higher frequencies. The insights and the next steps. The Excel solver function is always a great help to find the layout for a good antenna match. The construction of the antenna for a wavelength of 70 cm is easier than for higher frequencies. However, the measurements with the nano VNA caused me unexpected problems this time. I had resonances on my entire measurement setup, because the whole measurement setup was smaller than the antenna. Connecting long wires to ground eventually helped me get some usable readings anyway. In high frequency engineering, thicker is often better because of the skin effect and in order to make the structure as sturdy as possible. I would therefore recommend, if possible, to build the antenna out of a stable copper tube. Okay, now of course we are all curious how well the antenna performs in real ham radio operation. In a previous episode, we did statistical evaluations with a LoRa radio connection at 866 MHz. The results were really surprisingly good. I will link you to the video on the top right. However, amateur radio works with completely different types of modulation, and the scenarios for the radio fields also look somewhat different. So stay tuned to learn how the antenna actually works in real operation. Now stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe and support the channel. See you soon in the coming episodes.